Your parents may have taught you how to pray. Maybe they're doing mistakes and you don't even know it. They probably don't even know it themselves. So we as Muslim must learn to pray properly, exactly the way Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed. And we must pray on time. Don't delay your prayer. Nothing is more important than praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's only 5 times a day. And it's actually a beautiful break time from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us human. Think of this. Throughout the day, we go to work, we go to school, we go, you know, we have a lot of things to do. People usually break to eat maybe 2-3 times a day. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That's the norm. That's the known. Some people don't, some people do. That's not the issue. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us a beautiful break to take time off from work or school or anything else to go pray to Him to seek help, to seek refuge. Obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so He can reward us and bless us and protect us. A time to really clear your mind of things. Take a break. Go make the wudu. Wash yourself. Clean yourself. Wake yourself up. Purify yourself. We all know that when we're making wudu, by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your sins will actually drip from your body part that you made the wudu with, just like the water drip out of your body. You wash your hand with the wudu. When you're done, the water is dripping off your finger. Bad deeds are dripping as well by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His mercy. And that's a big blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And think about how clean Muslims are. We make wudu 5 times a day. We wash most body parts that get dirty throughout the day. The hands, the arms, the face, the ears, the hair, the feet. So compare us with non-Muslim. We are extremely hygienic and clean and pure. Non-Muslim, how often do they wash their face a day? Once, if they did it even. If you ever go to college and you notice in the college dorm, nobody even washed their face. They wake up, they're drooling, they look horrible and they go to class. What's going on here? Not Muslim. Muslim wake up in the morning, at Fajr time, wash themselves, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then at Dhuhr, then at Asr, then at Maghrib, then at Isha. We're clean, we're pure, we're ready, we're awake. It's a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have those 5 prayers per day to organize our day and give us a break, spiritual break, so we can actually concentrate on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, concentrate in praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for things, asking Him for things. That's a beautiful break. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to tell Bilal bin Rabah radiallahu anhu, his mu'adhin, arihna biha ya Bilal. Give us some comfort in calling for the prayer so we can pray and we can feel rested and comforted and peaceful. If you're praying and you're praying really fast, you're not taking your time with khushu' and concentration, you're not really benefiting from your prayer. The prayer is not the physical movement back and forth and up and down. No. It's basically complete concentration for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're taking time off from your life for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's given you a blessing and a time to beg Him and pray to Him and plead to Him for mercy and reward and help and, you know, an easy life. So dear brothers and sisters, do learn how to pray properly. Establish the prayer on time according to the description of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayer and concentrate and have khushu' during the prayer. The next one, and prior to going to the next one, I want to hit back to the testimony of faith. Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. It is very important that we understand its meaning and apply it into our life. We have to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only Lord who deserves to be worshipped. Because Christians and Jews and Buddhists and whatever other religion or sect, they think they have other gods. We know that the only God deserving the act of worship toward Him is who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. The cow for the Buddhist, does it deserve to be worshipped? They call it a god. Is it really a god? No. It's a creation. It's an animal that defecates in the street. So it does not deserve to be worshipped. Buddha, the idol, the sanam, the statue, the sculpture, does it deserve to be worshipped? It's man-made. It's made from copper or gold or silver or plastic, whatever it is. It's a toy. Does it deserve to be worshipped? They call it God. No. The only God who deserves to be worshipped by human is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alone with no partner. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. Ahadun fardun samad. One. He's not like the Christian claim, three in one and one in three and that nonsense. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. And he does not have a child or children, and he does not have a wife or a spouse, and he does not need anybody. We all need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we must believe that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, is the last and final servant and messenger and prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he was sent to all mankind and jinn on top of it. The last prophet sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all human and jinn on top of it is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We must believe in that. We must defend the honor of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We must learn the biography of the prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we must follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all his action to survive this life. And we must also love and respect the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam companions, the Sahabi. We must adore them, love them, copy them, and no, don't ever dare to say something bad about any of them. So this is a message for anybody who follow a bad sect, and those sects, some sects actually curse the Sahabi or make dua against them, wal-ayadu billah. Be careful of who you are. Watch that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you, and you will get punished for that. Don't ever dare and say anything negative about any of the Sahabi, radwanullahi alayhim. Moving on to Ita' al-Zakah. I just went back a bit for extra information and detail about the testimony of faith. Now we are moving to Ita' al-Zakah after we've already talked about performing and establishing the five daily prayers on time properly. Ita' al-zakah, paying your zakah, paying the charity that was specified by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to all the needy and the poor people that deserve it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the wealth, gave us the money, gave us the power to work and collect and make and save. Sometimes in life people are poor or ill or sick or not able to make money, or they have issues, or orphans and all those people. We as Muslim who were blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with wealth and money and good jobs and education, we must pay the zakah. And the zakah is a specified amount of money that must be paid if you have the limit, you know, it was set by the Prophet Muhammad.